My last year of high school, I took a physics class, and I was probably the only student that cared. And we made a simple circuit and turned on a light bulb with a battery, and I just was like, this is so cool, I want to know more. So I decided physics, and I was interested in stars, so I started taking elementary astronomy, and then I took the higher division observational astronomy and astrophysics with Dr. Ringwald, and I loved it. And so now I'm doing research with him in the graduate level. So I kind of just love it.
I desired to become a teacher when I was very, very young. And I still love it because you can really do something very good for students. You can help them explore topics that you love. You can help them design their future and making important choice for their lives. But at the same time, I also love to do research, to be engaged in high-level science, collaboration, and so on. And here, the teaching load is quite intense, which is expected to be, and that is one thing I really love. But on the other hand, I am both allowed and even strongly encouraged to build my research group, to engage in collaboration. So that was the most important factor.
I think my greatest achievement at Fresno State is the establishment of a research lab and program in the area of X-ray fluorescence applications in medicine and biology. I think that was a critical step in securing my first large grant from the National Institute of Health and allowed me to work with about a dozen students, mostly undergraduate.
I was born and raised in the Central Valley, and I was always surrounded by the Fresno State culture and always excited to be a part of it one day when I was ready to go to college. After my undergraduate degree, I had the option to go to other schools for graduate work, but I decided to stay at Fresno State because I felt like I had a really good connection with the professors and I enjoyed the research that I would be doing, and it just worked out perfectly for me.
We've had students that have gone on to international laboratories. One example is the students that have worked on the ATLAS project. ATLAS is a detector at the Large Hadron Collider that basically is trying to figure out how the basic structure of the universe works. Since 2009, every summer we've sent anywhere from 3 to 8 students over there using grant money from the NSF, money from the university, to send the students over there to do research. More locally, we have an outreach course that's run by Don Williams, where he takes students, he trains them how to explain basic science concepts. It's not the sort of high-flying, cutting-edge research, but it's also taking science and making it interesting and making it appealing to a broad range of K-12 students. And that's a huge service to science because you want students to be interested and engaged in science and hopefully maybe even choose science as a career. The Downing Planetarium is another way the physics department connects with the local community. This has been a fantastic sort of outreach to the community, and you know, we have students that have come into the physics program now who say, oh, I remember when I was a kindergartner, I came to the planetarium and saw a planetarium show, and Dr. White inspired me to go into science and actually to come here.
We do have that close-knit feeling between all of our staff, our students, and our professors. It's really nice that our department is so small.
I would say don't be afraid to reach out to your professors. Get involved in their research and try and find opportunities on campus outside of academics, maybe in a research lab or something of that setting to start getting experience before you graduate.